In this video, we're going to take a look at environment variables in GitHub Actions and how you can set them. As it says, GitHub sets default environment variables for each action run, but you can also set your own custom ones in your workflow file if you'd like. So as we've seen in the previous videos, we have the workflow file, we have individual jobs, and then we have steps. And when you're setting an environment variable, you have the ability to set them at each of those levels. To show how this works, let's now hop back into our project. And I've trimmed everything down just so we can focus exactly on what we care about here. Display is the name of our job in this case. And to set an environment variable or multiple on this level, you would write env colon, and then within here, enter and tab in, because now we're creating a dictionary off of this. Here's where you can start to set various keys and values. For example, let's say we wanted to create an environment variable called platform, and then colon, and then you want to provide the actual value of this. So let's say in this case, we care about the platform Azure. And let's add two more. Let's say region central and profile path profile, something like that. So how would we use this? Let's call this first step display custom environment variables. What we'll do here is we'll add a run step. I'm going to make this multiple lines. So we'll add the pipe and say echo the platform is, and then there's two ways that you can reference this. The first way is as it shows over here, which is by using this env keyword and wrapping it this way. So you could say instead of day a week platform, the value of this platform, it'll bring it in here. So that's one way you could do this. Alternatively, you could say the region is, and you could just do region. So the difference is here, you can use this variable this way. If you're using it within the run command, it's already setting that variable within the Ubuntu runner, and then we can just reference it here as if it's already set. Whereas this style, you're going to want to use if you want to use it anywhere else outside of a run command, any other part of the workflow. So for example, here they're using it in this if condition. If you want to use it as part of a condition or something else within your workflow, that's where you're going to want to use this wrapper. For example, here, if you wanted to do this if command, if platform equals central, you would have to reference this variable this way. You couldn't do it like this because this can only work within the run command. Let's keep this as it is and just prove how this works. So I made a mistake here. I see this actually failed. What I need to do is add jobs here. I missed this layer here. So I'm going to add this and then we'll rerun it. Okay, so I've made that change and pushed it, and now our change is running. And after looking at it again, I see I'm referring to region here and platform here. And you know, I was thinking about editing this out, but at the same time, I'm leaving this in here because this is the reality of being a data engineer. You have these small misses that it's one word or one character that you miss that drives you nuts and you miss it. So I'm leaving it in here to show one, I'm absolutely not perfect. And two, for anybody else who's learning and thinks that people just get everything right the first time, that's just not the way it works. There we go. Okay, so this time we can see it did run because I changed this to match what that should be. And here we can see it's echoing the platform is Azure. So it worked using it this way, and it also worked using it this way. All things considered, that's what I wanted to show you with this specific step. Next up, I want to show you, hopefully a little more successfully, how to use the GitHub environment variables. There's a couple default ones here that you can use, and they suggest using it where you can. For example, trying to reference where certain file paths, you know, the file system rather than hard-coded file paths, you can use stuff like this. So what we'll do is add another step, and I'll just print some of these out so you can see how it works. Let's get rid of this if condition. We don't want those problems again. So in here, I'll go GitHub actor. And here we can reference in this way again, because we're running it within the run command. Could do it this way, could do it this way, but for simplicity, I'm gonna keep it like this. And we'll do one more. I'll say GitHub ref, push these changes so that we trigger the workflow, and let's see if it prints it out for us. Here we see it's running. Let's hop in here. So it displayed the custom environment variables. This worked as expected. And here we go. So the default environment variables worked as well. So you can see here, it's passing in these values, which are defaulted from GitHub itself. And you can use this however you want and be a little more dynamic that way and avoid having to write things that may be given to you out of the box. So I hope you found this helpful. Feel free to like, comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you at the next video. Thanks for watching.